that channel. I've got dug that channel all the way up to the edge, and we kept that side completely dry. It's start filling up now, but we've done it. Now we've got another bit to do here. We on it, as you can see. That bit here up to the tree line. Now you can see the channel, it comes in there, and I dug another channel at the back all the way there. Reconnected it to the existing channel where I dug earlier. I blocked that off, and I also blocked that one off there, as you can see. So now we should have a completely dry area here. I'll let that water go here now. So if anything happens, I can lock it back up. I just wait until the water actually get out of it. day. You got pretty much close to the end, and I managed to keep the water out of the job by digging a trench here, like I said earlier. So it had all been out of water. There's barely any water in here, but we got the last bit here, which is underwater. So what I'm gonna do, swap the waters around. I let that going in like that, as it is, just dribbling. I blocked that up here. I'm gonna let that water come into here quickly and then build it back up. And yeah, we should have that side dry. See how it goes in a minute. Thank you. bits here. All done. We're doing the last bit now, pulling it up to the long range. And as you can see in the morning, I swapped it to like, I was filling up this side. Just about had enough time to clean this side. So we get rid of that patch here. Now, and tomorrow, I let the water in, and it's gonna come in anyway, because that's coming in from the ditch over there, far side. So that's why it's built up. Eventually it comes over, but we just had enough time to do this side, so it's perfect. Overnight then we'll come up to this side and the whole pond fills up, and tomorrow all I have to do is take that pond down there.